friends, today I am going to talk about the structure of stupa. As I have discussed in my previous video about stupa, I am sure you all know the basics of the structure. It is basically a burial mound and it is meant for ritual veneration. It is seen as a symbol of Buddhism since it contains the bodily relics of Buddha or in some cases some venerated monks who were associated with Buddha. Before Buddha, these structures were quite simple and uninspiring. But after the parinirvana of Buddha, we start to see more elaborate structures as now they came to be associated with Buddha. They were seen as a direct form of Buddha, marking his presence in this samsara, the world. Let me show you a diagram of stupa which I have drawn for you all. As I speak, you can spot various details of the stupa structure in the diagram. So on the solid earth base was kept the bij. The bij meaning the relic which consisted of the ashes and bones of Buddha or some venerated monks. And these relics were kept in an urn or some kind of earthen pot which was made of terracotta or in some cases made of some precious metals like gold, especially in the case of Buddha. And over this urn was constructed the hemispherical dome called the anda. This structure became one of the root causes of the spread of Buddhism as it was seen as a place of pilgrimage. The anda is also intended as the replica of heaven because of its association with Buddha's parinirvana or the passing away of Buddha. The brick wall surface of the dome was finished off with a thick layer of plaster. The wall surface sometimes even had recesses which were left for keeping small lamps to be lit on festive occasions. A certain amount of color or gilding was also applied as decoration. At the top of the hemispherical dome rises a balcony-like member called harmika. The harmika enclosed the yashti, the long stick-like structure which rises from the crown of the dome. The yashti further supports tiers of circular discs known as chhatra. The yashti with chhatra together is called the chhatra yashti. The chhatra yashti was planned on the summit of the dome as a mark of dignity. You can also see my video about the auspicious symbols related to Buddha where I have described the chhatra in detail. The chhatra rises in elevation with discs of diminishing sizes, the circular discs. The chhatra yashti almost appears to be like a tree. There are various interpretations while we look at chhatra yashti. So I'll share with you three interpretations. Number one being, it can be seen as a tree rising from the bij, that is the relic. The second interpretation is that it could be the tree of enlightenment, that is the Bodhi tree. And the third one says that it is also a tree under whose shade Buddha rests peacefully. The Buddhist ritual consists of circumambulating the stupa, for which a processional passage was built. This is known as the Pradakshina Path. The Pradakshina Path was provided by enclosing the stupa with a large wooden railing called the Vedika. This was sometimes made in stone as well. The Vedika consists of various parts like the thamba being the vertical posts, the suchis being the horizontal crossbars, and it is topped by Ushnisha, that is the coping stone. The practical function of the Vedika was to separate the sacred precinct from the secular world. The stupa also had entrances, usually at the four cardinal points. The stupa also has sopana, which is the staircase. In some structures, we see sopana like that of Sanchi Stupa, where we can see an upper and a lower Pradakshinapath. The decoration of the stupa was limited to railing and gateways initially, and gradually we see that more elaborate relief decorations come up. So friends, this is my understanding of the structure of stupa. I hope you liked today's video. If you have any queries, please comment in the section below. Thank you.